This is a summary of the Cpec dosing guideline for carbamazepine, oxcarbazepine, and variation in the HLA genes. This guideline was last updated in December 2017. Due to the increased risk of severe cutaneous adverse reactions, the guideline recommends that carbamazepine is not used by patients with the HLA-A *3101 allele, while both carbamazepine and oxcarbazepine should not be used by patients carrying the HLA-B *1502 allele. The HLA-A *3101 allele has been linked to a number of carbamazepine-induced severe cutaneous adverse reactions, while the HLA-B *1502 allele has been linked to Stevens-Johnson syndrome or toxic epidermal necrolysis induced by either carbamazepine or oxcarbazepine. The exact mechanism by which HLA-A *3101 and HLA-B *1502 interact with carbamazepine and oxcarbazepine to cause severe cutaneous adverse reactions is not well defined, but is thought to involve CD8 positive T cells. Genotyping results for HLA-A *3101 and HLA-B *1502 are reported as either negative for patients with no copies of either allele or positive for patients with one or two copies of the HLA-A *3101 or HLA-B *1502 alleles. These are the Cpec dosing recommendations for carbamazepine. Patients who are negative for both the HLA-A *3101 and HLA-B *1502 alleles are at a normal risk of developing carbamazepine-induced severe cutaneous adverse reactions. These patients can be given carbamazepine using the standard dosing guidelines. This is a strong recommendation. Patients who are negative for the HLA-B *1502 allele but positive for the HLA-A *3101 allele are at an increased risk of developing carbamazepine-induced severe cutaneous adverse reactions. If the patient is carbamazepine naive and alternative agents are available, then carbamazepine should not be used. This is a strong recommendation. There is very limited, if any, evidence linking the HLA-A *3101 allele and severe cutaneous adverse reactions induced by other aromatic anticonvulsants. As a result, it is not possible to make a recommendation regarding the selection of alternative aromatic anticonvulsants. If the patient is carbamazepine naive and alternative agents are not available, then carbamazepine can be considered for these patients with an increased frequency of clinical monitoring. Carbamazepine treatment should be discontinued at the first sign of a severe cutaneous adverse reaction. This is an optional recommendation. If the patient has previously used carbamazepine consistently and without incident for at least 3 months, further use of carbamazepine can be considered with caution. This is an optional recommendation. Note that tolerance to carbamazepine in a patient is not indicative of tolerance to other aromatic anticonvulsants. Patients who carry the HLA-B *1502 allele, regardless of their HLA-A *3101 genotype, are at an increased risk of developing carbamazepine-induced SGS-TEN. Carbamazepine should not be used in these patients if they are carbamazepine naive. This is a strong recommendation. Other aromatic anticonvulsants have weaker evidence which links the HLA-B *1502 allele and SGS-TEN. However, caution should still be exercised when selecting an alternative agent. If the patient has previously used carbamazepine consistently and without incident for at least 3 months, further use of carbamazepine can be considered with caution. This is an optional recommendation. Note that tolerance to carbamazepine in a patient is not indicative of tolerance to other aromatic anticonvulsants. The dosing recommendations for carbamazepine can be found in Table 2 of the guideline. Detailed footnotes pertaining to the recommendations can be found at the bottom of this table. These are the Cpec dosing recommendations for oxcarbazepine. patients who are negative for the HLA-B *15O2 allele are at a normal risk of developing oxcarbazepine-induced SGS-TEN. These patients can be given oxcarbazepine using the standard dosing guidelines. This is a strong recommendation. Patients who are positive for the HLA-B *15O2 allele are at an increased risk of developing oxcarbazepine-induced SGS-TEN. Oxcarbazepine should not be used in these patients if they are oxcarbazepine naive. This is a strong recommendation. Other aromatic anticonvulsants have weaker evidence which links the HLA-B *15O2 allele and SGS-TEN. However, caution should still be exercised when selecting an alternative agent. If the patient has previously used oxcarbazepine consistently and without incident for at least 3 months, further use of oxcarbazepine can be considered with caution. This is an optional recommendation. Note that tolerance to oxcarbazepine in a patient is not indicative of tolerance to other aromatic anticonvulsants. The dosing recommendations for oxcarbazepine can be found in Table 3 of the guideline. Detailed footnotes pertaining to the recommendations can be found at the bottom of this table. This guideline has been annotated on the PharmGKB website. This includes a drop-down menu where an activity summary can be given for specific combinations of alleles. The activity summary includes implications for the patient's response to carbamazepine or oxcarbazepine, the appropriate dosing recommendation for the specific HLA genotype, and the strength of that recommendation. Remember that variation in other genes, in addition to demographic and clinical factors, including concomitant medications, can affect treatment. It remains the responsibility of the clinician to determine the best course of treatment for a patient. Cpic and PharmGKB assume no responsibility for any injury to persons or damage to persons or property arising out of or related to any use of CPIC's guideline or for any errors or omissions. The guideline itself and supplementary information are freely available at the PharmGKB and CPIC websites. You can access relevant pages using the links in the description below this video.